We're now going to discuss a patient with a cervical herniated disc, a herniated disc in the neck, and this person ended up having some spinal cord injury because of it. So on this side view MRI, as we saw in the normal one, again, brain is up here. This is the spinal cord coming down through here. Again, the white stuff, cerebral spinal fluid. These are the vertebra, and again, these are the discs. We can look down at the C5-6 disc here, and we can see that there is a disc herniation back here. And you can see it's compressing the spinal cord, and that spinal cord compression is causing this patient some symptoms of a condition called myelopathy, or spinal cord dysfunction. We can see the cord itself has a uniform color until we get here, where we can actually see some increased white or signal change within the cord, which is an indication of some problems with the cells within the cord. We can look at it from the top-down view, and again, this yellow line shows us where this cut is. And this is normal here. You can see the spinal cord surrounded by the CSF with the nerve exit zones. And as we march down the spine, we continue to see that the spinal canal is nice and wide open. There's still plenty of cerebral spinal fluid around the cord up until the point that we get to the injury, where we can see the herniation is causing significant deformation of the spinal cord. And if you look carefully, you can see this white area in the cord. And if we go down to the level right below the herniation, you can see the white area over the cord injury level within the cord at the level below. But this is the level, the herniation, that is causing that compression. This is a stir image of the spinal cord. This is very similar to the T2 image that we saw where the water was white. You'll see with the stir image, the water is still white, but the fat back here and the fat in the bones is suppressed. It allows us to see inflammation with a better vantage point. And again, if you follow the spinal cord and you see where the injury is, you can see all of the edema in the cord because of this herniated disc compressing the cord. This is a comparison of the injury cervical spine to a normal cervical spine. In the normal cervical spine, you can see the spinal cord is free all the way down. There is white CSF on either side and this white signal of the cord, which you don't have at the normal level.